book haul time. Feet first and I landed too hard. A broken ankle, karma rules. You never saw my birthmark.
Book haul for you guys. I randomly went to my Barnes & Noble and didn't know they were moving, so I'm kind of at the end of the sale, but they were doing 50% off everything in the store to get rid of the stuff. So to start off, I got the rest of a series that I had bought the first book in, and it's the Mirror Visitor series, and they had all the rest of the books still there, so I bought all these and got them each for like $5. Okay, next I got one of the books in the Kingdom of Wicked series. I don't have the other two books, but because they didn't have the other ones, but I want to read them eventually, so I got this one because it was 50% off. Okay, next I got 99% Mine by Sally Thorne because I actually just finished the Haiti game not recently and I loved it, so I wanted to get more by her, and I heard this is kind of similar, so. Next, I got the new release by Talia Hibbert because it was 50% off and this just came out, and I've seen so many people get this, so I was really excited when I saw this. Okay, next they had the new book by Allie Hazelwood, and she's one of my favorite authors. I love both the books I've read by her, so I was so excited to see this. Okay, next is a book called Intercepted. I haven't seen too much about this, but I saw a YouTuber I follow get this and it seemed interesting enough, so. Okay, last book I got from the sale is We Can't Keep Meeting Like This by Rachel Lynn Solomon, and I loved Today, Tonight, Tomorrow by her, so I wanted to get more books from her, and this was there, so. Alright, and this book wasn't part of the sale. This is actually from Target, but I just wanted to show it because I bought it today, and it happened one summer, and I just had to get this because I have been wanting to read this. I know it's a summer book, but I just have been dying to read this, so. And that's the end of my haul.
I'm back with another book haul, and I'm actually really excited for this one. I'm excited for all of them, but I'm still excited. Let's just get into it. So I got 3 from Barnes & Noble and 5 from Amazon. We're going to start with Barnes & Noble. Literally the first book I saw when I walked into Barnes & Noble was Brutal Prince, and I freaked out because my Barnes & Noble never has Sophie Lark. And this was like the only book that they had, and I was shook, and I was like, mine. And then I saw 2 Wrongs Make a Right. I've never heard anybody talk about this, and if you've read it and haven't shared it with me, why haven't you? It looks so freaking good. I'm so excited for this book. I'm so excited. I kind of like skimmed through it and read a little bit, and it is so spicy. And you know. And then I got The Perfect Marriage because, you know, having a little mystery moment, you know what I mean? This has to do with some type of mistress getting murdered, so I'm here for it. The freaking frat boy! I'm so excited for this. I have read the first 3 in the Nashville series, and I am so excited for this one because that series was so good. I think I read each book in a day or two. It was so good. This is my next read. I'm so excited. Now getting into my Amazon. Change on the Fly by Maren Moore, and then I got the second one, Sincerely, the Puck Bunny Maren Moore. First of all, I'm obsessed with Maren, like, obsessed with her. She is the sweetest person, and she's constantly supporting me and right back at her because her books are freaking fantastic. If you haven't read a book of hers, you need to go right now. These are also in my Amazon storefront, so you can just quickly grab them. And I love her, and I'm so excited to read these. Last but not least, I got The Right Player by Candy Steiner and The Wrong Game. These covers are freaking gorgeous. Gorgeous. I have read 4 of Candy Steiner's books now, including the Red Zone Rivals series and her Weightless book, and all 4 have been amazing. I loved every single one, so I was like, I ran out of Candy Steiner books to read, so can't go wrong. These are so freaking cute. Look how pretty these are. I can't deal. All my book hauls are good book hauls, but this book haul, she's fire, because this is a really good lineup. Just saying.
Hi, my name is Caitlin. For people who don't know me, and for those who do know me, hello, welcome back. And as you can see, I'm here for a book haul. These are really heavy, so I'm gonna put them down. So I went to Edinburgh. I flew back in last night, and I bought over 30 books while I was there because books were extremely cheap. I'm gonna show you all them today. I'm gonna separate them by store, because most stores were doing deals, like 3 for 2, 3 for £10 or whatever. So I'm going to separate them by store and show you what I got. So I'm going to start with The Works, because that's where I bought most of my books. All the books I bought in The Works were either £3 or £5. So extremely, extremely cheap. So I bought loads while I was there. So I'm just going to get cracking. So the first one I bought was They Both Die at the End, and I got that for £5. Next is Daisy Jones and the Six. I got that as well, £5. This is The Good Girl Complex by Elle Kennedy. I got that for £3. Soulmate Equation by Christina Lauren, paid £3. How to Kill Your Family, I got that for £5. The Keeper of Stories, got that for £3. Once Upon a Broken Heart, got that for £3. Then I got the A Good Girl's Guide to Murder trilogy, and I paid £5 a book, so that was £5. That one was £5, and that one was £5. There was loads of like series in The Works that just weren't for me, but they were extremely cheap. So if you're ever looking for books, The Works, like, can't recommend them enough. They have a website, get on there. This is all the Colleen Hoover books I bought while I was there. Without Merit, I got that for £5. Point of Retreat, paid £5. Finding Perfect, £5. That felt like a bit of a rip-off. Like, there's literally, like, nothing there. But I love Colleen Hoover, so soz. Confess, paid £5. Losing Hope, paid £5. Slammed, £5. And then the last one I got was Heartstopper Volume 4. This is the only one I didn't have, and considering it was only £8, I just picked it up. So, yeah, that's all the books I got in The Works, so I'm going to move on to the next shop. So I'm going to quickly do W.H. Smith, because I didn't buy much there, and I'm kind of running out of time, so I just want to do it real quick. So W.H. Smith in the airport, we're doing buy one, get one free, so I got 2 books there, and they were The People Next Door and The Family Game. I got the 2 of them for £13. And I'd never heard of them before, but they just look really good. Read the blurb and I was like, yeah, buying that. Rest of the books will be in part 2.
Okay, I have a lot of books, so let's get into it. So before I go through the first bag, I'm just gonna basically explain why I've got this many, because it's an obscene amount. So it's my 21st birthday in September, and my boyfriend said he'd get me 21 books for my 21st birthday, because books is literally all I want. I am obsessed with books, so that is why. So I'm really excited. Most of these in this bag are the cheap ones, because they're from The Works. So I don't think he realised how much books were until he bought the Waterstones ones compared to The Works ones. So yeah, he was blown away. So the first one I got was a cheap one. It was £2.50. It's the Happy Ever After playlist. I've never actually heard of this book. Literally the only reason I got it is it was at the till and it was £2.50. And I was like, oh, that sounds really cute. So I think she finds a dog and it happens to be this man's dog. That's all I remember from the blurb. I'm not too sure. Anyway, on to the next one. So obviously I had to get Finding Cinderella. I've not seen this anywhere. I've seen the old cover and I didn't like it, so that's why I didn't get it. And then I saw the new cover in the works, so obviously I had to get it. The only annoying thing, it doesn't match the series that it's in. It's, I think this is in the Hopeless series. That does not match the black covers whatsoever. Anyway, that's another bone to pick. And then I got another book by Sally Throne. I think that's how you say her name. She wrote The Hating Game. I've read two of her books now. And I did enjoy them. I really loved The Hating Game. And then 99% Mine. It was good. It was good. So I'm excited to read this. So yeah, as soon as I saw her name on the book, I was like, I've got to get that. And then this one, A Brush With Love. I don't know why I got this. I really, really don't. I just found it hilarious that it was toothpaste. That's literally the only reason. And then this one I was really excited about because it's Christina Lauren. I've not actually read any of her books, but I've got near enough all of them apart from this one. So did I have to buy this when I saw it? Yes, I did. And plus it was only £3. How can you complain about a £3 book? You can't, can you? And then obviously Finding Perfect, £5 for that. Nearly shocked my boyfriend into next week. But yeah, obviously if I was gonna get Finding Cinderella, I had to get Finding Perfect. And then these from the works, from Waterstones, I was so excited for. Honestly, I was in Wales and I was walking, just having a gander. And then I saw, let me get it out. I don't know if I can lift it. I've got 5 seconds left. Go to the next video.
I went sourcing with Lynchy and I'm gonna try to do this fast. This new bookstore, St. Vincent de Paul, their books were 80 cents today because the books were only $1 and it was 20% off the entire store. So I got this, I got this, and I got this, and I got this for $1. Oh my God, we were at the Goodwill. I love the classics, and this Heffa actually has read the classics and she owns the classics, but the classic books are in my bedroom because I think they're aesthetically pleasing, so I keep them in there and keep all my other books in here. I still have some classics in storage. This show is so cute on Netflix if you haven't checked this out. I think they're on like season 4. It's kind of like if Hallmark had past 9 bedtime, so it's a little bit spicier than Hallmark, but the story is so cute, and I think they're on season 4, so if the books are half as good as the show, which we always know it's going to be, doing that. Down here I have Cassandra Clare. I don't have this copy. I'm just praying that it's not the one that's taller because my Clockwork Princess is too tall too. Beauty, Phantom of the Opera retelling. I saw this on my Tiki Talk. I hear it's good. 5 Feet Apart, and then this, the another book by the same author, so this movie was fantastic. I actually got a copy of Verity on my own and then found another one today, so I'm going to be doing a schmiv away for my birthday. Love that for me. And then like I said, my Game of Thrones are up here and I'm so excited about this size. Anyway, stay tuned for my schmiv away. Bye.